right now on ITV, here with a new series and a new look. Holly and Philip are back together for This Morning.
This Morning, it's me versus the weeds.
Boots sponsors This Morning.
Welcome to your new look this morning. Look who's back. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Didn't just say about
10 seconds ago, I've got a really nervous
belly. I have. I can feel it. Just as that music started then, I was like, yeah, no, it's fine. It's like coming home. It's lovely. And then... But it's nice to be here, except for... A, you said there was a load of money to be spent on a lovely new set, and B, it was going to look fabulous.
Well, actually, we did spend... quite a bit of money on the outside, actually.
Oh, wow.
There you go. Look at that. For the first time ever, we're branded outside. We're painted. So if you walk past, you know where we are.
Give us a wave. That does look rather lovely, doesn't it?
Those people don't look even remotely interested.
No, they don't, do they?
They're not fussed at all.
Look up!
So we ran out of cash at the inside.
Oh, that's a shame. I mean, where are we going to sit?
But look at this! Drop the cloth!
Ta-da! Wow.
So, cool. It's unbelievable.
This is our brand new home. Do you like it?
I think it's the best it's ever looked.
No, I really do.
All the walls taken down, completely wide open.
It feels so much bigger. I know it's exactly the same studio. Before anyone says, oh, they've moved studio, it's exactly the same studio, exactly the same windows, but it just feels like we've got more space.
A little bit of a... Oh, pick that up. That's broken. Brand new, that was, for this show. We've got, obviously, a new little area here to sit.
Are these real?
We'll test it out. Are they real? They've probably been fireproofed.
Are they?
I ate some on the telly once. I had a piece of toast and someone ran up to me and said, don't eat that, it's been fireproofed.
Has it been fireproofed?
Yes.
It's been hollyproofed. It's very nice.
New kitchen.
I like this. I like the curves.
Yeah.
I feel like we're doing an advert. La la. Isn't it nice?
Yeah. And then round here.
What's round here?
A little breakfast bar. We'll come back to here in a second. We'll have a chat about your summer in a few moments.
And your summer too.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then over here.
This is the important bit.
I don't know why I'm showing you this, because this is as new to me as it is to you.
Make yourself at home, Willoughby.
It's quite firm, isn't it?
It is quite firm, isn't it?
Yeah.
Fancy.
Over here.
What's over here?
This is an interesting new area.
Okay.
It won't always be like this.
We have guests, Philip.
Hello there. They can't speak because they're concentrating at the moment.
Oh, I see.
Because there is...
a lot of money.
That is a real, absolute, genuine £1 million.
Really?
£1 million.
That's got £1 million in it. They won't talk to me, will they?
No, they won't talk to you. Don't touch it. Look, do you see him tense then? He went.
Try him again.
Whoa.
I'm not going to mess with
it. It's ITV Daytime's massive giveaway.
So that is £1 million.
An actual £1 million giveaway.
God,
serious cash. And someone will be getting their hands on that lot. Hopefully it will be you.
So lots of changes. Is there anything that hasn't changed?
Do you remember the hub?
Yes.
Well, and then we got the iPad, so we didn't really need the hub anymore.
Yes.
And then Rylan got really busy, so he couldn't get booked.
And then we had the Alpine Chalet.
And then we went through here, we had an Alpine Chalet, which I think we used once.
Yeah, that didn't work.
Look what we've got!
Oh, bless you. I'm just coming in to give you all kisses because I haven't seen you all for so long. Oh my god! Hello, Denise.
Hey, gorgeous. How are you?
I missed you all loads.
Welcome back.
How are you?
So if you're watching the telly at any stage and wondering, I wonder where the This Morning family are. They're always in here. We never let them out. They sleep in here. They live in here. It's like the Big Brother house.
And is this the usual spread we have here?
No, it's really not. They've just really pulled out all the stuff. I'm just going to put it out there.
Is this something to do with you?
It looks
well,
like
I've been holding Cornwall all summer, so I thought I'd bring you back some goodies. Cornish pasties, scones, clotter cream. I know it's your fave.
It is my favourite. And I see you put the jam under the cream.
Yeah. But that's the Cornish way.
Yeah, that's the Cornish way.
The Devonians would be up in arms now.
Yeah,
there
right.
We are.
They will. But you've been in Cornwall, so that's why you're having
it like
that.
Great ideas.
Not saying which way is right or wrong. We don't want to get into scone games.
And is this fudge?
Yep. Now it's got Cornish sea salt on it.
Has it?
Yeah, you try that, kid. And we've got Cornish pasties, Phil. I know you get a bit withdrawal symptoms.
Could you please save me one of those?
I can. There you go.
I've been in 5 minutes and I've already eaten two things.
How was your summer, Denise?
Wonderful, but the viewers have never stopped writing in, so I've been writing letters all the summer.
Yeah,
we've got some fashion with you later, haven't we?
Absolutely, yeah, we're thinking pink today.
Look at Denise, were you inspired by Denise?
Definitely. Absolutely accidental.
She's always in fashion.
She says that.
How about you, Chris?
Great summer. Was away with all the family, my grandchildren as well. Brilliant holiday.
Lovely.
And I had a very important birthday at the weekend.
Oh, 35?
Yeah, big 7-0.
Well, Chris!
Happy birthday to you. And Rylan, I'm looking forward to talking to you later because if, like anybody else watching the telly on Sunday night, you were in floods of tears, Simon Cowell crying on The X Factor.
Yeah, so it's been such a good launch weekend for The X Factor. I went to the press launch last week and they are all so on form and ready. Plus, if you haven't already voted, you haven't got long. You can choose what judge is going to get what category. So head to Twitter now to do that, because that's going to be shutting at 12 o'clock today.
Okay. And a very busy summer of soaps.
Indeed, and we're looking forward to autumn now. And we've got an exclusive of the new Corrie promo on the live episode coming up later.
Cool. We're going to be chatting about that a little bit later on. You're going to be back a little bit later on. Chris, we've got a chat with you. Gok, Denise, you're in, I think, later on in the week, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah, and Phil, thank you very much indeed for those. Don't forget to save
my... It's lovely.
I know, it's good, isn't it?
Did you have a big party, Chris?
Yeah.
Did
big.
You?
Oh, yeah.
Of course he did.
All your friends? Yeah. Did you get an invite to that?
No.
We'll be seeing all of them throughout the course of the week and the morning. In the meantime...
So this is our breakfast bar?
Sit yourself...
It just serve tea?
I'm going to do this once and once only.
Oh, thanks.
There you go.
Thank you I thought, for a second there, I thought you were just going to follow.
No way.
Not day one, that would be mean.
Let's start with you.
Okay.
Because obviously this is the interview that everyone has been after.
Ah.
So how's it been? How was your year off?
It's been incredible. I'm really glad I did it because it was a big decision, I think, to sort of leave anywhere for a whole year and come back. It's been the quickest year of my life. I've never known time for. I mean, Chester's going to be one in a couple of weeks, so that's where did that go? But it was lovely, and it was really important for me and the family, and just to spend time. And Belle starts school tomorrow. So it's been lovely. It's been really lovely.
And what would you normally be doing at this time?
Well, I was saying this. So 11 o'clock, although he's a bit old now, so he doesn't have his 11 o'clock bottle, but when I was watching this morning when I was off, hello, all those mums who are feeding, breastfeeding, bottle feeding, whatever you're doing. 11 a.m. feed was the moment. Right now, you'd be just gathering your feeding pillow around, you'd be getting yourself settled, you'd have the remote, you'd have some water, probably a couple of biscuits, if I'm honest, and you'd get ready to sit down and watch this morning. And it's like, it was a lovely part of my day doing that.
How's he fitted into the family?
Who, Chester?
Yeah.
Oh, so good.
What are Harry and Belle like with him?
They're brilliant. And actually, it's funny, because I think people sort of say, oh, gosh, three, are you mad? It must be so much work. But I find that it makes Harry and Belle better because they kind of just have to... They've sort of grown up a bit because they know I've got Chester and I can't... With three of them, I've only got two hands, so you can't do everything. So they kind of have to, you know, Belle's really good at getting in the car on her own, put her own seatbelt on. Like, she's a little bit more self-sufficient, you know. She sort of had to grow up a bit. And they love looking after him, which is really nice.
And Harry's really grown up.
He's really good.
I know you don't, and I think very sensibly, you don't throw pictures of the kids around.
No.
So you do keep that to yourself.
Yeah, but
we're very lucky because we spent a lot of the summer together.
He loves you, my Harry.
Which is fab.
I said to him yesterday, I went, oh, Mummy's going back to work tomorrow. And he was like, with Phil. He was like, can I come? No.
So we've had a lovely summer with the kids because it's been a very sociable summer with families. But also when the kids went to bed, We had a bit of fun, didn't we? All got together, there we go.
This is Philip's famous barbecue night. So there's some other faces you might recognise there. There's a Declan Donnelly on the corner and an Ant McPartlin over there. And that's all for your girls at the back, Wyatt, Steph and Dan.
Steph's sister in the back.
This was your barbecue night. Phil, you might not know this. In fact, you should do this on here. I know it's not barbecue season now, but I still think in the winter a peri-peri chicken.
Ah.
And your peri-peri chicken wings... you should definitely do.
We had a night where the boys, Anta Deck, came over and Holly came over and I'd done a whole load. I'd done chicken wings, I'd done absolutely everything. And Holly, in the car over, said to the boys, oh, he does great ribs. So they all arrived expecting ribs. And actually, the disappointment in Deck's face when I pulled out chicken.
I know, I'm really sorry, but that was... You do very good ribs, too.
Thank you.
We could do that next year.
Yeah, well, there's an item for... Yeah, we really are thinking ahead. I want to show you this picture, actually, because our big moment during the summer was the fact that Molly graduated from Leeds, and it's her first day at work today.
Oh, good
luck,
Molly.
She started work today. If she's allowed the telly on in the office, she might very well be watching, so...
Good luck, Molly.
Hope you're having a good first day.
First day's all round. And this is the week of... I think some of the schools went back last week, didn't they? But Bell starts tomorrow, so big changes this week for everybody.
Do you want a cute video?
Which one?
What about the little boy and the gorilla?
Oh, the cutest video. Yes, this...
I just wanted to show you this, because it was online.
So this is a little boy here. This is... What's his name? We haven't got the name. This was posted by Sherry Chute. This is her two-year-old son, Asaya, there you go, meeting two-year-old gorilla named Kamoli last week. This is at Columbus Zoo in Ohio. They are playing peekaboo and hide-and-seek. I mean, as if that game couldn't get any better, and then you play it with a real-life gorilla.
And it's loving it as well. Look at that. There you go.
Isn't it brilliant?
We would love your comments. As always, we've got our iPads here on the set, so we've got instant access to what you're saying, so do get in touch. We'd love to hear from you. Welcome back.
Thank you.
So, whilst we all get settled, let me tell you what's coming up. She's bright, blonde and bubbly. We have got a brand new face in the family, and it's not Holly.
What?
That news is coming up in just a few minutes.
OK, I see. Also today, just after 11, is the story of the summer. The tens of thousands of migrants risking their lives to get to the West. We're live on the Greek holiday island of Kos, where Mark Williams-Thomas is following the migrant route and exposing the Mr. Biggs of the people smuggling gangs.
Then, just before 11:30, we are live to Aberdeen, where Jeff Brazier is attempting to keep the summer going by fake tanning hundreds of the locals.
And our guest today for the start of our new season is the man of many talents, Rob Brydon. He's here at midday. It's such a busy show, but I think there is room for something else. We have a royal exclusive. We'll tell you a bit more about that after the break.
This morning, her stabilisers are coming off.
Boots sponsors this morning.
When I'm not working, I just want to let my skin breathe, but I still want to look nice. Garnier BB Cream does everything that I need. It moisturises, evens skin tone, covers, brightens, and it's got UV protection. If only everything in the morning was as easy.
I was really worried about Ivor, so I took us off to get tested, and actually, I'm just as bad. Flora Proactive came to Rutland with a three-week challenge to lower our cholesterol. It was about a healthy diet, exercise, and eating Flora Proactive every day.
Really? That is absolutely brilliant.
Don't cry.
I can't actually believe it's been such a small change, and it's made such a big difference. I really can't.
Hi, one sheep. Sally from York is asking, can Plenty clean porridge stickiness from my baby's high chair? You bet, pretty lady. You see, it's wettable, ringable, strong as bull. Pieces of cake, Sally. Have you got Plenty wet? And now introducing Plenty Easy Clean Wipes. The last wipe is as effective as the first, thanks to the unique dispenser. Woohoo!
At Unilever, we want our brands to help create a bright future. Hellmann's Real Mayonnaise is made with free-range eggs and is on its way to sourcing all its vegetable oil sustainably. Which is good news for sandwiches and our planet. Unilever makes some of the world's most well-known brands, and many of our food ingredients are already sustainably sourced. Sustainably sourced oil is just one of the ways we're helping to create a bright future.
Sadly, Freddy's got used to the odour in his bedroom. He no longer smells it. Yes, he's gone nose blind. So we helped break the news.
Oh,
Febreze Fabric Refresher eliminates sweaty odours in teenage bedrooms.
That's pretty impressive.
One of the many ways Febreze helps you and your guests breathe happy.
And to eliminate odours and freshen your car, use Febreze Car Vent Clips and breathe happy.
Is there a dog food that's good for my immune system?
Good for digestion.
For healthy teeth and bones?
And a shiny coat?
Yes, there is. Pedigree. Professional nutrition for all dogs. Pedigree. See what good food can do.
Lint excellence. Luxurious sensations in a thin masterpiece. So thin. So intense. Excellence. Experience the unexpected with Excellence, a touch of sea salt. Lindt, master chocolatier since 1845.
This is for the weekend prime times, the unforgettable crimes. For a lifetime of walking that same cobbled street, 60 years have given you the front row seat. A season of specially commissioned programmes to celebrate 60 years of ITV. Continues tomorrow at 8 with You Saw Them Here First Hall of Fame.
This morning, I'm thinking wedges.
Boots sponsors This Morning.
There we are, we're inside. Welcome back. There's someone I would like Holly to meet now.
She's keep hearing about this person.
Our newest cast member. She's a historic signing for This Morning. She's blonde. She's bright. She's very pretty. She's excitable. Still extremely young though, and she's just around here.
What?
Hello there.
Your
hello,
guess is as good as
darling.
Mine.
Oh, you're,
I have
I'm getting
no
a
idea.
Big old
fact,
lick.
He might have gone. He might have gone down South Bank on a Segway. Are you joking? Oh my God! Hello, hello! Oh my God! Oh, who are you? Oh, kisses, kisses!
Yes.
Oh my gosh, who is this?
Well, we've followed our newest member of the This Morning family all the way from birth. 11 weeks ago, when she was born. She's the cutest thing ever.
Is she staying?
She is staying. Would you like to hold her?
Oh, are you joking? Yeah. Can I just say, it wasn't long ago I started a campaign to get a dog, and now you've gone and got one.
Ah, yeah, but this one's got a job to do. It's not just a random puppy that was what you wanted the last time. We thought, no, we had to have a purpose. We had to have a reason. This is a pup with a job to do.
On June the 12th, Labrador Ushka gave birth to 8 healthy pups at the National Breeding Centre in Warwickshire. But these pups are meant for more than just being adorable and fluffy, as they're raised in the hope that they could one day become guide dogs for the blind. At 6 weeks old, the litter are put through a trial to test their social skills and discover which are likely to become successful guide dogs.
So, having put her through all her paces there, quite a few tests for her to go through, she did really well, actually, and of all the puppies that we've tested from this litter, she's definitely the most level of all of them. I think Phil and Holly will be very pleased with her, and I think this is your This Morning puppy.
It's now time for the puppy to leave the breeding centre for the next stage of her development. This involves spending time with a real family. During this stage, the pup will learn basic obedience commands.
Place it.
Yeah. Lovely. Very nice.
Training.
3 blasts on the whistle and she can have her food.
And how to behave around adults, children and other animals. And the next stop is the This Morning studio.
And here she is. So our little pup, who you will get a chance to name, we'll explain all of that a little bit later on. Is going to be with us for the next year at least as she gets to socialise with us, getting used to obviously the noise and general life in a studio, meeting loads of different people. So to tell us more about what's in store for her is Jane George from the Dogs Charity. It's the Guide Dogs Charity. So welcome to you.
Good morning.
Why was she selected then? What makes her suitable?
So at 6 weeks old, we kind of screen all of our puppies, and obviously they have to be very healthy. They have a very, very active working life. And also it's about their personality, their attributes. And what's particular about this puppy is her confidence and the levels of intelligence that she's shown, her ability just to cope with every day.
And how long does the training last for then?
So there's different stages of training. So for the first year, she'll spend time with Emma, as we've just seen in the film.
Yeah.
And Emma will kind of socialise her. She'll teach her some basic skills about how to cope with living every day and getting out and about.
Yeah.
And then she will go into one of our training schools.
Because, I mean, as we said there, she does have a really, really important job to do, and we aren't here to get in the way of that at all. So what can we do when she's here in the studio with us to sort of maintain her training, to make sure that we don't get in the way or throw her off track? Because she's not allowed to sit on the sofa, is she?
No, she's not allowed to sit on the sofa. She's OK on your lap, as long as she doesn't get too excited. And the great thing about being in the studio is that it's something she hasn't experienced. It's the only way she'll experience it, and it will teach her to cope with the unexpected, which is what guide dogs have to do once they're fully trained.
So for us, what are the guidelines? Not allowed on the sofa, and as far as having a sleep is concerned, and food and things, she's going to be with us at least twice a week.
Yes. So her puppy walker will be on hand to support you, and she'll eat four times a day at this age, and then it kind of gradually decreases as she gets older. She has to have some rest, so she should really only be active for sort of in bursts of about half an hour,
and then
have some rest. But it'll be fine, you know. She's going to have her own playpen on the set, so if she's sleeping in there, we wouldn't disturb her and take her away to be quiet. We're happy just to let her be. Absolutely.
So where does she go when she's not on the telly? Who looks after her then?
So she's with Emma and her family, she will be with Emma for the first year of her life. So.
And when will you know whether or not she is completely suitable?
It's a constant process of assessment. Because of the amount of screening we do of our puppies, we're quite confident before we put them into the training programme that they're going to make it. But who knows? I mean, obviously health issues could develop, or, you know, she could show signs of just, you know, being easily distracted, which is not a good...
Not suitable. And so what happens then? I mean, if she does all this training and then, you know, close your ears, puppy, if she's not suitable, what happens to her then?
So we have a long list of other jobs for dogs that don't make it to be guide dogs.
So a companion dog.
We provide dogs to other assistance charities, and we also help. You know, sometimes dogs, if they're following their natural instincts to sniff, become and go and work for the police, for example.
Oh,
so,
wow.
So there are plenty of alternative careers.
Nippy little teeth.
<she doesn't>
Yeah, it was my fault because I put it there.
You don't want the silver fox. You want the ginger fox. Okay. Don't get confused.
Well, she is absolutely, absolutely beautiful, and she's going to be with us for a bit. And also, we are going to ask you at home if you would like to choose a name for her. But there's a way of working this, because with guide dogs, the litters are named after certain letters that you choose. So
yes, it's a guide dog's tradition, and she comes from a C litter. So we'd welcome viewers' contributions to ideas for names.
Anything beginning with C.
And it's got to be one or two syllables.
Exactly.
Yes. So not a complicated name, and not a name that sounds like a command of any sort, a confusing sort of a name.
Exactly. So, you know, obviously down and off and those kind of commands that we use all the time with dogs. So
nothing like that.
Bethan says...
I'm sure everybody's going to fall in love with
I know.
That.
Does that count as sitting on the sofa if her bottom's on there? Does it?
Oh, gosh.
You already broke the rules.
Oh,
you've undone all the hard work.
I know, sorry. Feet on me.
Let's hope... people understand how important guide dogs dog's arse, says Bethan. Kitty says, you've got a resident dog. Amazing, it's made my day. Oh, my gosh, she's too cute. What a lovely idea, says Siobhan. Sarah says, the puppy's just too much. Finally got a puppy for the show. So happy, says Rachel. So we'd love your suggestions for names. So remember, it's got to be, it's got to start with a C, one or two syllables, and nice and simple, and fun, and don't make it sound like a command.
Yes.
And we'll be launching that puppy poll a little bit later on. It is your chance to name our pup.
OK, now it's time for you, hopefully, to win £1 million.
Or
can
pop
I give you
puppy
unnamed
there?
Puppy back? Puppy gorgeousness.
Of course. See you later,
see
unnamed
you later.
Puppy.
And really nice to meet you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'm sure we'll see you again. Thank you very much.
In celebration of ITV's new season on daytime, we are making history by giving away the most we have ever done in a competition.
So here is what you need to do for your chance to win.
Text cash to 86060. Text costs £2 plus one standard network rate message. Call 09068 786060. Calls cost £2 plus your network access charge. Or post your name and phone number to MIL 3615, PO Box 7558, Derby DE10NQ. Entrance must be 18 or over. Lines close at 5 p.m. on Sunday, the 20th of September. Good luck.
Yeah, the very best of luck. Should also say that the three network users may not be able to enter at the moment because there's a problem with that network. Other networks and entry routes are still available. Should also point out, don't forget that that puppy is a girl.
Oh, yes.
No, it's a girl's name.
Girl's name.
There we are. We've got to work our geography out of how we're walking
know,
here,
haven't
we?
I know, it's all a bit new. Time to talk health with Dr. Chris, who is back for the 27th year. This series, we're going to be bringing you more health news than ever before, at least twice a week. And we've got a brand new strand called Second Opinion, which will be coming up on Thursday, where, as it sounds, we'll have two doctors giving not one, but two opinions.
So let's start, first of all, with a couple of headlines, if that's all right, Chris.
Yep.
And one of them was the new meningitis B jab.
Yeah, I mean, this is very important. It's a new jab against meningitis B. And it's actually the first national and publicly funded programme against meningitis B in the world. So we're leading the world here. Mm. And meningitis B, it's a condition that's most common in babies and children under the age of five. And the vaccine gives 90% protection.
Wow.
And the effects of that meningitis, of course, you know, about 1,200 cases a year, one in 10 die, others are left physically disabled,
yes,
mentally disabled, legs amputated, horrendous condition.
So when would your baby receive this? Is that how it works? It's something that's rolled out
That's
and available?
Right. It's in the vaccination programme now, starting today, in fact. So 2 months, 4 months, and 12 months.
So what would happen for my Chester, for example, or Harry and Belle, who are 6 and 4, what would happen with them if I wanted to get them covered?
Well, I mean, they may well be covered through the computerised system that we use, and therefore you may get a notification from your GP or your local clinic to take the child
along. So it's
not
too late? They can still have it later on?
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's a catch-up programme for children that are older at the stage, 3, 4, 5 months. They'll be brought into the programme fairly quickly as well.
OK. Yeah.
And the next one was, if you sleep less than 6 hours, the chance of you getting a cold quadruples.
Yeah. So what?
Those are your health headlines for today.
Yes, well,
so what, says the doctor?
Well, the common cold.
What
come
are you bothering
on
me for?
No, well, I think what's interesting here, I mean, they did show, they studied 160 patients and looked at their sleep patterns, and those were the poor sleep patterns. When they were all given nasal drops containing the common cold virus, those were the lower hours of sleep were, of course, four times more likely to get the condition. What it does show is that sleep is really, it's classified as the third pillar of health. Mm. You've got diet, exercise and sleep, because during sleep your immune system...
What's optimum sleep then?
Well, yeah, I mean, one here's 8 hours, and I think that's about right, because you've got all sorts of things happening when you're asleep. Your immune system's been stimulated, white cells are working, tissue's been repaired, absence of sleep, increased risk of blood pressure, depression, all sorts of other problems, so it's vital.
But people need different amounts of sleep depending on the person that they are anyway, don't they?
Yeah.
We're actually going to surprise Dr. Chris now, because we're going to celebrate the amazing life-saving advice that he's given over the next few weeks, bringing you together with the people whose lives that he has saved. Doesn't know anything like
no, he
about
doesn't.
This, which is why he's looking a little bit confused.
We'll give you a clue. Do you remember this bit of advice that you gave 4 years ago?
I think I should, at this point, mention the symptoms. So this is very important. Yeah. One is bleeding after sex, and this is what Rachel experienced. Bleeding between periods. Women say, oh, just breakthrough bleeding, you know, it's nothing. Bleeding after the menopause. Yeah. Pain during sex, usually deep internal pain, or an offensive smelling discharge. If you've got any of those symptoms, get to your doctor and discuss them.
Well, one person who took notice of what Chris said was Kim Doyle, and she wouldn't be alive today without you. And she's right here now.
She's Kim. Welcome, welcome.
Hi, Kim. Welcome, hello. Welcome to the show.
Oh, thank you. Waited for that hug for a long time, Kim. Haven't you? Oh,
that was just,
so you, you went to work and then you went back home again particular day. Why?
Yeah. I'm self-employed and I left for work very early at about 7:15. Forgot my breakfast, so when all my staff were in, my manager very kindly said to me that morning, "Sure, Kim, go home. It's only a 5-minute drive." Went home and made myself a cup of tea and a couple of slices of toast. And
so you didn't rush back to work then?
No.
Which, thank goodness you did, because that slice of toast and turning the TV on,
absolutely.
And it was the 6 health checks that we just rewatched there, and you said you felt like Dr. Chris was talking to you.
Absolutely. When you looked into the camera, it was like that scene in The Matrix where all those doors go click, 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 click. And everything you said was just exactly what was...
You had those symptoms, yeah?
Absolutely. Every one of them, but just in varying degrees. Mm. And
so you went to get yourself checked because you knew there was a problem. You knew you were in trouble.
As soon as I heard you explain the symptoms and the way you explained it, I said, that's me. I have that.
And you're, like a lot of women, a little bit fearful of going and having a smear test. But you immediately went and booked.
I did. I rang work and I said, you know what, I'm not coming back for a couple of hours. Mm. And I rang my GP, who the nurse was there, went for this smear test. And when she was performing this smear test, I bled very heavily. Mm. So went off to hospital the following day. And on the morning of the 11th, and this was the 8th of February, and the morning of the 11th was given the news that I had stage 3 cervical cancer.
You said that you weren't shocked by that because you'd been prepared for it.
No, Dr. Chris had told me.
Yeah.
I knew. Mm. Yeah.
And how are you now?
I'm in remission. I'm really good. That's 4.5 years ago. I had 53 radiotherapies in 2 different sections. Okay. One for the tumour in my cervix and around that area, and then just above it because I had a couple of lymph nodes that were a bit suspect. Yeah. And then I had 3 internal brachytherapies. Oh. And I had 6 chemos initially in 2011 and 3 more in 2012.
Gosh. We know that, I mean, Gary's in our green room.
He is,
so he's enormously grateful that you're here as well.
But my family is.
You want to say something to Chris?
Yeah, I just thank you so much. I can't tell you what it means to me and my family. I mean, both my sisters have celebrated their 50th birthdays. My grandson will be 7 now next Saturday. My parents, I'm the youngest of 3 girls, and for my parents, I can't tell you that moment. Well, so thank you for all you do.
Yes, but the good thing, you responded. Reacted
and that is so important. But well done, Chris.
That's important.
Thank you so much for coming in. Stay well. Yes,
thank
absolutely.
You
well done, Chris. Well done. Right, still to come, we're staying with the feel-good factor, keeping summer going and stopping those tans from fading. And the man with the tan is Jeff in Aberdeen.
There he is. And he's keeping the summer alive by giving out free spray tans. Where better to do that in the so-called Granite City?
Aberdeen might be getting a late taste of summer thanks to Jeff. But what's in store for the rest of us today? Here's your local weather.
It was supposed to be the hottest day since records began.
What? Since last week?
Yes.
Hello, good morning. According to the Met Office, today is the start of autumn and it is feeling a bit fresh out there today. Tomorrow, more of the same, some nice sunny spells, but also the risk of 1 or 2 showers. The reason it's feeling quite cool is we've got this northerly airflow bringing in cool air from the Arctic. It's not going to be freezing cold, but just feeling quite fresh, a couple of degrees below what we'd hoped for at this time of the year. So temperatures getting up to about 18 or 19 degrees out of the breeze and in the sunshine, feeling more pleasant certainly than it was yesterday. This afternoon, though, we could see one or two reasonably short and sharp showers as well. They'll clear up overnight, which is then dry and really quite cool as well, so feeling a little bit fresh. And tomorrow morning, we get off to quite a nice start, actually. Fair bit of sunshine around, reasonably bright, a little bit of cloud just building as we head towards lunchtime and into the afternoon, similar to what we've seen this afternoon, really. Always the risk of a few scattered showers around, heavy in a few places, and we'll be a little slow moving as there isn't too much of a breeze. Looking further ahead, things turning a bit drier as we head towards the end of the week. Just an outside chance of showers on Thursday. Friday and Saturday, dry, though it is going to be looking a bit cloudier. I'll see you later. Goodbye.
Yes.
Welcome back. Plenty still to come this morning. We're live to the Greek island of Kos with the story of the summer, an update on the migrant crisis from Mark Williams-Thomas. Good morning, Mark.
This is a true humanitarian crisis. Join me in 7 minutes when I show the migrants' journey from Turkey over to Greece.
Thank you.
Thank you. And between now and lunchtime, look who's back. It's Gok, Sharon and Rylan. Either they're the oddest band to audition for The X Factor or they're here to talk about fashion, soaps and showbiz. Rylan, in particular, is championing our Fab Four from the Philippines. They're going to be here later.
The girls are live with us a little bit later on. But now we've got our massive £1 million giveaway here. That £1 million, tax-free cash, could be yours. Stay with us and you'll find out how.
We've been inundated with your reaction to our new puppy. I knew you'd love her.
About 700 tweets so far suggesting names and saying that everyone thought the puppy was absolutely
hashtag
gorgeous.
Hashtag name our puppy. Yeah. Put your name on there. Got to begin with a C.
Hashtag name our puppy.
Name our puppy.
Call her Cara, says Sinead. It means friend in Gaelic.
Oh, that's sweet.
I like that.
That's really nice. Louise says Connie would be a great name for the pup.
Lisa says, I think you should call the pup Cilla in memory of the late Cilla Black. Yes.
And Ryan says Coco would suit very, very much.
Candy says Kerry, because she's so cute.
Lots of C's in that sentence. Steph says call her Carrie.
Chloe says Freya.
Morgan says you need to call her Clover. Clover's cute.
That's a pretty name.
That is sweet.
Cleo. Has to be Cleo, says Beth.
And Nick and Liam both say Cassie. So lots of names there, but keep them coming in. If you can think of something better that you think the puppy should be called, get in touch.
Yeah, we'll be revealing how you can name our puppy a little bit later on in the show. First, how about taking part in the biggest ever ITV daytime competition?
Look at that. Right here, right now, is £1 million in cash. It's real. It's not just telly money that we printed. Not that we do that, but you know what I mean? You know when they have fake money and all. We don't just print our own money.
Well, I don't, do we? I wonder why my checks get bouncing. They've given it away on game shows, obviously, but never in a competition like this before. There isn't even a question to answer. So here's what you need to know for your chance to become a millionaire.
Text cash to 86060. Text costs £2 plus one standard network rate message. Call 09068 786060. Calls cost £2 plus your network access charge. Or post your name and phone number to MIL 3615, PO Box 7558, Derby DE10NQ. Entrance must be 18 or over. Lines close at 5 p.m. on Sunday, the 20th of September. Good luck.
Having negotiations with our two gentlemen here during the course of that competition as to whether or not I'm allowed to actually touch it.
What was the outcome?
The outcome was a very reluctant yes.
Wow. So are you going to do it?
Could I ask
you? Well, while you open the bottles, I'm just going to say three network users may not be able to enter at the moment, but other networks and entry routes are still available. Go on, then.
So just guide my hand anywhere.
Down. There, you're in it.
Right there. So let's just go down. I'll go down a couple of stacks. I'll just do that,
Just do that.
Look how new it is. Lawyers are probably going absolutely spare. And just so you know, that could be your dosh. £1 million.
I've never seen. Well, obviously, I've never seen, but I didn't. Just look at it. It's
do we deliver it like that? Or can you have a cheque?
Through the letterbox.
You know, through the letterbox. We'll post them packet by packet through your letterbox. good luck.
Right, still to come today, a proper royal exclusive. And here's me thinking this place smelled of fresh paint on my behalf. Can you guess what we're about to reveal in a few minutes? Stay right here.
This morning, I've picked breakfast.
Boots sponsors this morning.
Herbal Essences invites you into the mystical jungle. Shroud your senses in a delicate veil of coconut kisses. Dive into a bottomless lagoon of moisture, the essence of follicular vitality. Take your hair to paradise.
Go buy our shampoo.
Ever feel like you go unnoticed? Enough.
L'Oreal Paris Age Perfect.
It's the science I trust to help me look like me. Nourish your skin and show those age spots who's boss. Look and feel more radiant.
Age Perfect from L'Oreal Paris.
So are we worth it?
More than ever.
Wanna get closer?
Let's go. Capital!
It's 24/7.
From the moment you get up. It's hits.
Hits!
Tune in to Capital.
Boom! Pow!
Wanna be part of it?
Well, now you can.
The biggest artists.
The best music.
The hits now.
Number one hit music station. Capital.
To make me feel best.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
This audition has just changed your life.
Yes. People are going to be obsessed with you.
Expect the unexpected. The all-new X Factor. Available now on ITV Player.
This morning, it's me versus the weeds.
Boots sponsors this morning.
Welcome back. A very appropriate spectacle live outside our studio window this morning is the London Fire Brigade's Thames firefighting launch, Fire Dart, sprays its water cannons in honour of our exclusive royal announcement. Let's just have a moment to look at that and watch.
Isn't it wonderful?
They were spinning as well. It was. Look at that.
How brilliant is that?
What's lovely is to
I've
be able to see a spectacle like that without the horror of there being a fire. So it's quite nice to actually
watch what they can do.
So
it's incredible.
Manoeuvrable. It's. I don't know whether they can hear me on the boat. Can you spin it?
Oh, I think they did.
That's
oh, it's brilliant. So I bet you're wondering what our royal exclusive is. Well, I'm going to tell you. Next week, we are being visited by Her Royal Highness Camilla, the Duchess of Cornwall. She is going to be given a tour by us of this very studio to celebrate ITV's 60th anniversary.
We'll be on our very best behaviour. It's a shame she can't do this week, otherwise she could have helped us name that pub.
Oh, yeah, she could have done. She
Camilla!
Oh, with a C!
Three syllables.
Oh, yeah, it can't be. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Oh.
So that is next Wednesday on This Morning. That's us, that's you and the Duchess of Cornwall.
How brilliant. Now, our makeover certainly had a big reaction from you. Do you approve? Let's see. We've had some comments that have been sent in.
Have we?
Oh!
OK, it had to fall down at some stage. There it is.
Where's the iPad? I said to you, I can't be in charge of the iPad.
Oh, God,
too many things to think about.
What did you want us to talk about?
The studio. Have we
the
got
studio?
Any of those?
There it is.
Loving the new titles, says Dill.
There we are. And Samantha says, love the new set. Thank you very much.
David said, the new opening titles are brilliant. Well done, team.
And Queenie says, loving the new set and the introduction. Holly, you look amazing.
Oh, thank you.
Let me just scroll down for what she said about me. No, no. No, nothing there about me, Queenie. Thank you very much.
Well, keep your comments coming in. We love hearing them this morning.
The story of the summer has been the migrant crisis, and it shows no sign of abating. Have a look at this picture. It shows the sheer desperation and emotion of a Syrian father who's just landed in Greece with his family and their worldly belongings, all packed into a rucksack. They're struggling to find that picture, but I mean, I'm sure you can imagine the horror and that heartbreak that they have to go through.
Well, tens of thousands like them made a similar journey this summer in rubber dinghies across a dangerous stretch of water between holiday resorts in Turkey and Greece.
Well, the holidaymaker numbers may be dwindling, but it's still the front line in this crisis. And Mark Williams-Thomas has spent several days in Turkey and Greece there on that story where it shows no sign of ending.
Well, Mark's alive now on the Greek island of Kos. Tell us what you've come across so far, Mark.
Good morning. This is mass migration on an incredible scale, and actually you've got to see it to believe it. I've followed the migrants as they've made their journey across the many beaches in Turkey, across a very, very dangerous sea, over to the many beaches on Kos on the island of Greece, as they start their journey into Europe. Here's my report. Behind me are the latest arrival of migrants, those that have been stopped trying to make the trip across from Bodrum in Turkey to Kos. For many others, travelling with families with young children, they will still continue for the next 5 hours before they land on the beach in Kos.
This video given to us by one of the migrants shows the moment they first set foot on European soil. This small boat carried, amongst others, an engineer and a university lecturer seeking a new life away from the troubles of their native Syria. All night, every night, migrants arrive on the holiday beaches of Kos after a terrifying journey in the pitch black. Many have been separated during the crossing. All are exhausted and emotional.
So you've just arrived. Where are you from?
I'm from Iraq.
From Iraq?
Yes.
And how dangerous was that, coming across the sea?
Oh, is that more dangerous?
Straight after landing, they all head towards the police station in the hope of getting their papers to carry on their journey.
Behind me is a queue, and over the next few hours, this queue will grow, possibly into many thousands. These people are hoping to get on the boat that is going to take them to Athens on Wednesday morning. These people really are living hour to hour with the hope that they can leave this country and carry on into the rest of Europe.
Mark, it's absolutely heartbreaking to see such sheer desperation. But like you said there, this is just the first leg of their journey, isn't it?
Yeah, many of them have travelled already for weeks, some of them even months, to make it to Turkey. And then, of course, you're on that perilous journey, and it really is very dangerous. I've been out there, and I can tell you, at dark time, which is when they travel because they try to avoid the authorities, you cannot see in front of you. So they are literally going from one coastline to the other coastline, following lights. And the people that I've seen, this really is for them the hope to flee their war-torn countries, such as Syria, Iraq. Some of these people coming over here have got no other options, they feel, other than to try and find something to better for their family. And we've seen over the last months some of those really sad images of people. Indeed, you can see from my report there, speaking to one father who was so delighted that he'd made it across the sea with his children.
So what's the plan throughout Europe to cope with this? Because I'm assuming this is a massive strain on resources there, in other parts of the Mediterranean that are dealing with these enormous numbers. What's the plan?
Yeah, this is just one coastline, and the coastlines across the whole of the country. You know, are full with migrants trying to see that opportunity where they can gain in to and come to Europe. And what ends up happening is they come here and then they see this as an opportunity to move up to Athens, and then having moved from Athens, they then move up to Hungary, and they hope to move up to Germany, and then some will move down to France and across, as we've seen some of those pictures, across from Calais into UK. And it's such a sad story because these people have left behind them, in some cases war-torn countries, in order to try and find a better life for themselves.
So they will all be, if you make it across safely, and this perilous journey, we've seen so many people have lost their lives, but if you make it across and you land on those European shores, then you will be integrated within Europe. You don't get sent back.
No, they're not sending anyone back. The only time you get sent back is if you don't make it across the border, and that's the sea border between Turkey and Greece, because the Coast Guard will pick you up and they will return you back to Turkey. If you make it across and onto the shores of Greece, they will then accept you and they will then allow you to move up to Athens. And actually, over the next 24 hours, we will see the boat arrive. This is a government boat, it's a chartered boat, and they will take the people from here up to Athens, and then from Athens they can then make their way into the rest of Europe. And the numbers are truly shocking. They are absolutely massive.
So Mark, what's the plan for you next? Where are you going to?
Well, alongside my report that I've been making for the couple of days, that's been very much focused so far in terms of the humanitarian issue, you know, that real personal story of the individuals. But my next focus, which I have run alongside, is the traffickers. These people are making millions, and I mean millions, out of the exploitation of human beings. We spoke to one man last night for three people. He paid $30,000 just to bring three people over. I've already interviewed a number of people, and their stories are truly shocking. This is mafia organized crime. They are being taken from locations, blindfolded to hotels, and then when they get to the hotels, they are being taken to the locations for the boats. My report will be tomorrow, and I can tell you, it is truly shocking.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you very much indeed. We look forward to your comments on that story as well.
In the next half an hour, Jeff Brazier's stretching out the remaining goodness of the summer by trying to fake tan as many Aberdonians as possible. That's coming up shortly.
Actor Rob Brydon is our star guest, waiting for him to join us in the green room, along with our... That's not Rob Brydon.
There he is. And pink. It's the on-trend colour for the season, says Gok, and we're not going to argue with him. All of that, plus the X Factor girl band getting everyone talking. Fourth Power will be here with Brydon. We'll see you shortly.
It's all aboard for Alison Hammond. She's from Bram. They've got a canal. But we've sent her to the Grand Canal for La Bella Vita and the biggest stars of the Venice Film Festival. Jake, Johnny, Arpats and Eddie. Start Thursday on This Morning.
This morning, I'm taking them to the park.
Boots sponsors This Morning.
As a pup, all Quince did was sleep. Who knew one day he'd save a blind person's life? My life. When he was two, Quince became my guide dog. One time when we were out, we went across a main road. Suddenly, Quince tugged me back to the pavement. Seconds later, a car raced past. Quince saved my life. Whenever I go out for work or to see friends, I put my total faith in him.
Because without Quince, I couldn't be Dave.
But every hour, another person goes blind, which means more guide dog puppies need to be trained.
Sponsor a puppy like Quince, and you could change your life.
For just £1 a week, you can watch your puppy grow up with regular pup dates, photos, and even a cuddly toy. Please call Guide Dogs for the Blind on 0800 587 5522 or text puppy to 63333 and sponsor a puppy like Quince to change your life like mine.
When I'm not working, I just want to let my skin breathe, but I still want to look nice. Garnier BB Cream does everything that I need. It moisturises, even skin tone, covers, brightens, and it's got UV protection. If only everything in the morning was as easy.
Empower your freedom with the Jeep Cherokee and its new 2.2-litre engine.
Lint Excellence. Luxurious sensations in a thin masterpiece. So thin, so intense. Excellence. Give a zesty twist to your chocolate moments with Excellence Orange Intense. Lindt, Master Chocolatier.
Don't put your eyes down. You're not to blame.
I've seen real benefits from my patients using SenseTime Repair and Protect. It is an amazing technology. It actually does help repair sensitive teeth. If you have exposed dentine, you could get sensitivity. SenseTime Repair and Protect helps repair the sensitive part of the tooth by actually forming a layer of material which is harder than the actual dentine surface itself, reducing sensitivity in the long term. I recommend SenseTime Repair and Protect to my patients. It actually delivers to help repair sensitive teeth.
Please call 0800 587 5522 and sponsor a life-changing guide dog puppy. Thank you.
Nourished hair means better colour.
Oi, that's my line.
But with over 50 shades to choose from, it's not just about brunettes anymore. With Nutrice, nourished hair means better blondes. Multitonal, luminous.
And better brunettes. Richer, shinier, deeper.
And no greys. And now there's 50% more conditioner in every pack.
So there's even more reason to find your perfect shade. Visit Nutrice.co.uk.
Step by step, I gotta
play. Fight off!
Whoa! It even sounds sweeter when I talk. I said,
no. 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 No.
All right.
Check in for your dose of Doc Martin, Monday on ITV.
This morning, the weather may be dull, but I'm feeling bright.
Boots sponsors this morning.
Don't expect me not to dance if you play music like that. Welcome back. The sun is not really out in London at all, actually.
It's chucking it down, actually.
It is raining. It was like a welcome back. Here, have some rain. It's pretty rainy and pretty grim everywhere at the moment, isn't it?
Yeah, well, we're hoping that we're going to make summer last as long as possible.
Trying.
Actually, you've been sending us your summer snaps. So we've got Vedna from London sent us this picture of her cousin photobombing her on holiday this summer.
Oh, look, that's a good picture. Good keenie.
Good bomb.
And photo, we got this one from Ashley in St Helens. She said this photo sums up her summer travelling around Australia for 3 months. Oh, look!
And Anne from Ross-on-Sea says that she loves this photo of her daughter Scarlett photobombing her father and uncle.
Ah, that's lovely. And Juliet from Northern Ireland sent in this photo of a photobombing goat. Look at that.
Lovely. Thank you very much indeed.
Well, for many, the summer was a washout, especially in Aberdeen, which saw floods at the wrong time of the year. So we thought we'd take the sun to the Granite City in our own special way.
So we've got Jeff Brazier. He's in Aberdeen at the moment. How many Aberdonians has he spray tanned now? You'll find out in a matter of seconds.
Got Gwans waiting in the wings, ready to show us how to look pretty in pink in this season's must-have colour.
And things are spiralling out of control in Corrie. Sharon Marshall's got the storylines that will rock the soaps this autumn.
But now let's go live to Aberdeen, where we can find the lovely Jeff Brazier. Good morning to you, Jeff.
Good morning, guys. Yes, I'm here in Aberdeen in the Bonner called St Nicholas Shopping Centre, and we're giving away spray tans. Who wants this next?
Me!
They are literally loving life right now. Summer doesn't really happen for the guys in Aberdeen, so we was giving away, you know, spray tans all day yesterday. Have a little look at this and see how we got on.
Why does it always rain on me?
So today today's really cloudy and overcast. Is that the best day's weather you've had this summer?
Yeah, basically.
It's days like today. It's just grey, no sun.
Cold, wet, raining.
It always rains here. How can you get a suntan when it always rains? I think I'm going to look quite good, you know, because I'm quite pasty at the moment.
I was expecting it to be like orange and look fake, but it doesn't.
Well, I never had tan before, so it's a bit different for me.
The colour looks good. I can understand why people would go for fake tans and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. Like, no, I might go out tonight. I look good, you know.
So if Aberdeen doesn't get sunshine, we're going to bring the sunshine to them in the form of a spray tan. We must have done about 120 yesterday. We've done a good few this morning as well. So how does it feel to get a suntan? As an Aberdonian, have you ever actually brought any sun lotion in your life?
Yeah,
okay, back to 50 all the time. I don't know why she'd need that. So how are you getting on today?
Yeah, it's good.
How do you feel about standing there and, like, you know, everyone seeing what you're doing?
It's the most exposed I've ever been in a shopping centre.
And it's a good thing. The tan looks great so far. Keep it up. Okay, come on, let's have a little look. So, you look really brown now. How are you feeling about your spray tan?
Yeah, it looks really nice.
Is it the first time you've ever been brown?
No.
No? Okay, all right. But maybe not every local has never had a suntan in particular. We've got a guy here, same for the ladies. How are you feeling about having a... Are you a vain person, would you say?
No, not at all, no.
Not in the slightest, as he stands there in his shower cap. Anyway, the guys in Aberdeen here, they're loving the spray tans. We're going to try and get through as many people as we can. So back to you in the studio and see how many we've got done in maybe another 10, 15.
Jeff, before you go, come back, Jeff, I want to talk to you. How many times exactly have you been in the spray tan booth today?
Oh, listen, Holly, as you know, au naturel, I had a holiday maybe only 2 weeks ago, so I don't really need a spray tan at this point. And don't you dare challenge me to have one, because I'm in on the sofa with you on Thursday and I don't really want to sit there too brown.
Smelling the biscuits.
You'd be jealous.
Yeah.
You know what I'm going to say? Hashtag tan Jeff.
Yeah. I think it's got to be done.
Next time we come back to you, if you haven't got a shower cap and your pants on, I'm not coming to you.
Oh, Holly, come on. Don't be like that.
Yep.
You know, anyway, Sam, we've lost the connection with Aberdeen now.
Not here anymore, Jeff, sorry.
When we join in, he will be in a shower cap and pants. How lovely.
Right, well, I love the fact that you're going to have just that bunch of people wandering around Aberdeen that we've managed to get round to today. You're going to have everyone will know on the streets of Aberdeen who's been through the this morning tanning salon.
It's true. And if you're in Aberdeen, get down to that shopping centre and tell Jeff that he has to have a spray tan right now, courtesy of me.
Yep. Whilst Jeff takes the good people of Aberdeen and helps them to look at $1 million, let's see if we can help you to win £1 million.
It's never been done on ITV Daytime before, but we are going to make one lucky viewer a millionaire, and do you know what? It could be you.
Here's what you need to know for your chance to bank this incredible competition prize. Text cash to 86060. Text costs £2 plus one standard network rate message. Call 09068 786060. Calls cost £2 plus your network access charge. Or post your name and phone number to MIL 3615, PO Box 7558, Derby DE10NQ. Entrance must be 18 or over. Lines close at 5 p.m. on Sunday, the 20th of September. Good luck.
Yes, good luck with that. Now, three network users may not be able to enter at the moment, but other networks and entry routes are still available.
Right, I think it's time to get Rob Bride now.
Oh, you in love too.
Oh, he's fallen in love with our new puppy.
I know.
In you come, Rob. Oh. In you come.
Is he bringing the puppy with him?
He's going to bring the puppy with him. Yeah.
Come and join us. Welcome.
Hey, hello.
It's quite a long walk.
Are you a dog person?
I love dogs, yeah. Oh. I love dogs.
Oh, look. What's
how are
not
you?
To love?
Nice to see you.
Oh, look.
Have the paw.
Come and have a seat. Come and have a seat.
Hiya.
Lovely.
Nice.
I'm really, really good. Lovely to have you here.
So have you got dogs at home?
No, but do you know what? We got a cat, but I've been thinking about a dog.
Have you?
Because I'm more and more just loving them, you know? So this is fantastic.
And also everything that goes with a dog, like the walks, getting you out.
Yeah,
all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
But you haven't got much time for a dog at the moment because you are incredibly busy because tonight is your opening night, isn't
it? Well, it's the first preview, of this play at the Old Vic, Future Conditional. Very exciting. It's all about the education system in Britain at the moment. You're not allowed on the sofa. Come on. Now, listen, now there's no need
to... Put her down. If she wants to wander down, she can have a wander around.
OK, you can have a wander. There
she's
we are.
She's got free rein, apart from on the sofa.
There you go. Okay.
And she's 11 weeks old.
Yeah.
Gorgeous.
If you can let him go if you want to.
Yeah, because there's people there ready to a dog wrangle.
OK, so ready?
If you want to let her go. There you go, you are free.
This is when she does whittle on
Born free. There you go, just for the time being. And I have a look around. Because obviously it's very difficult to chat about your new play whilst you're holding on to a 11-week-old puppy.
So, yeah, first preview tonight is called Future Conditional at the Old Vic. It's all about education. I play a teacher, Mr. Crane, this inspirational teacher. A girl comes into my school called Alia. She's come from Pakistan where she's... You know, she's had terrible trauma in her life and she comes here and can't believe that she gets the opportunity to learn, you know, in the education
system. She's very bright, though, isn't she?
She's a very bright girl, yes. But the key thing is that she sees education for what it is, this wonderful feast of knowledge, which, where she comes from, she didn't have access to.
And that's not necessarily what the rest of the pupils see it as at the school. So there's quite a conflict there.
Yeah, you know, the teacher that I play, a lot of his time is taken up with crowd control, you know, and she can't understand why these other kids, a lot of them, don't want to learn. But then you also see the parents at the school gates. This is what I think chimes with a lot of people. As their kids are about to go to secondary school and they're having to make these choices, if they're able to make a choice, you know, are they going to go to a faith school, to the nearest school? Their parents moving to get within a catchment area. So it's very timely, you know, very
now. Looking through the eyes of the parents and the teachers and the pupils.
You see it through the teachers' eyes, you see it through the parents. You also see there's an education review board set up by the government. And the facts and figures in that are fascinating, you know, the stuff showing you where Britain is in the world tables. I mean, it's a really thought-provoking piece of theatre.
Am I right in thinking this is the first time this has ever been put on at the theatre?
It's a brand new play.
So is that... I mean, I can imagine that has its pros and its cons, in a way, because you don't know it, you haven't been to see it before or anything, but it must be quite nice to do something that's fresh, that this time... This is your character now.
But, you know, it's interesting. Tonight being the first preview, I can't wait to see what an audience makes
the
of
reaction,
it. Because I love it, you know, that's why I'm doing it. You know, I read it and I went, oh, this is terrific.
Well, there's 24 young performers there, so that is a bit of wrangling in itself to organise that on stage. Yeah. But I love the fact that it's directed by the guy that directed Matilda.
Matthew Warchus.
So Matthew knows how to deal with...
I mean, I've got to see him this afternoon, so I can't, you know, gush over him too much now or it'll be embarrassing. But he's a smart man. Watching him direct... Watching the decisions he makes on an aesthetic level, on a visual level, of where to put people. And I sit watching him directing scenes and I go, oh, yeah. Oh, that's a very interesting shape. He's a theatre person. He sees it that way.
What did your dad think about? Because you said, I read something a little while ago, that you were getting more and more and more. You're becoming your father.
We all do, though, don't we? Don't, I mean,
I'd love to become my father. He was a very calm, kind, gentle man, so if I became him, I'd be very happy.
You could be describing yourself.
Say,
you could be describing
you.
Yourself. I find it really interesting that the physical mannerisms, because obviously I haven't lived at home now for 7 or 8 months. You know, I'm trying to, you know, make it on my own in London. you thought I was serious.
Where's he going with that?
So I find it amazing. It must be just in the DNA, and my mother as well, the physical things that I do, which I don't witness that much now, but must just be in the DNA.
Yeah. What do you do then?
I find myself in social situations, the way I'll laugh at something, and I'll just go, oh, my word, that's just my dad.
My dad.
I'm just being a tribute act. to my dad or my mum, you know.
So what did he think about you getting into this particularly strange game?
Well,
acting?
They've always been hugely supportive. And when I think back now, I think, oh, my word, because I got 2 O-levels at my first attempt. You know, it's very hard to put a positive spin on that, right?
So at first attempt, did you have other attempts?
Well, of course, I didn't give up. You had to have 5 to get a grant to go to drama college, so I had to keep resitting the maths and... So, as a parent now, I think, oh, what must they have been thinking? But I never saw that. I think they always had faith in my ability. And I think there's probably something good in having a child who has a firm idea of what they want to do.
Yeah.
I think...
Oh, absolutely. I mean, there's many
that... helps, you know.
Were you a performer at school?
Yes.
Because you do the impressions now, don't you?
And I always did. At school, I was in the school plays. I was at school with Ruth Jones.
Yeah. Mm.
And she and I were in Guys and Dolls together, Carousel together, and that was my life. Once I discovered that, all the academic stuff just went.
But you're talking about your impressions. You, I mean, it is for me listening to it, and when you do that, it is such a talent. But you don't look at it like that, do you?
It's just a stupid. People come up and
but
they
it's
say,
very good. I mean, they are so spot on.
Yeah, but it's something you can either do it or you can't do it. You know, it's like some people are good at football. It's just a thing. You know?
I love the fact that you took over. Was it Ken Bruce's show?
Yes.
Did the whole 2.5 hours as him.
Yeah.
And people didn't realise
that
it was you.
No, on April Fool's Day, I think they thought Ken was ill or something.
Oh, didn't
something
people think that
right.
He'd had a drink?
He may have had a drink, yeah. I was sort of saying, well, Ken Bruce here this morning, and I'm going to be... I might feel a little bit looser today than I normally do, so... and we did the whole...
Didn't you say that Jeremy Vine was boring?
Well, yes, but I'm just, you know...
We know that that's part of the act and it was only a joke, but the listeners were outraged, and that's when they said, we think Ken might have had a drink.
It's on YouTube, and if you look at the comments, cos we did Portmaster, you know, Portmaster, here we go, who had a 1981 hit with You Drive Me Crazy? And people I've seen in the comments saying, oh, the actors that play the contestants on Portmaster, it was all real. They were real people, and they weren't told that it wasn't Ken. I was being quite rude. There was one guy who was in the Real Ale Society, and I said, so, John, you're a very heavy drinker, is that right? And he goes, well, no, Ken, I'm in the Real Ale Society.
That's brilliant.
And you're doing something with Tom Jones, aren't you, in October?
Oh, yeah, fantastic thing. A bit, it's called Tom Jones and Rob Brydon, which is, result for me.
Living the dream.
One Big Night for Children in Need. It's at Wembley Arena on the 8th of October. Music, comedy.
And will you perform with him?
I will perform with him, yes. And there's nothing he can do to stop me.
Absolutely.
In the meantime, Future Conditional, it's what we're talking about a moment ago.
Yeah.
It's tonight, or as we say, first previews.
Previews tonight,
tonight,
and we're only there till October the 3rd. So if people want to come, they need to get off their bottoms.
And this is at the Old Vic Theatre.
Will you stay with us to name our puppy?
I would love to name your puppy, Philip.
Would you? Good. OK. I'm very pleased. There's no one else I'd rather have do it than you.
I believe you.
Not just any old puppy, though. No. This is a very special guide dog in training.
Oh, but something is missing. We still don't know what she is going to be called. So that's where you come in, because we want you to name that pup.
It needs to be something beginning with the letter C, because that's the letter given to her litter. So they're very quite clear guidelines there. One or two syllables is best. And it mustn't sound like a command, so not too confusing. We've had 5,000 messages so far.
Oh,
you can email us your suggestions. So thank you very much indeed for that.
What would you name her?
I go for Chloe.
Chloe's sweet.
Camilla, obviously, as a mark of respect.
Yes, yes.
But it's too many syllables. So Chloe, Cara. Kira.
Kira's
a lovely name.
We've got Cookie. Cookie's suggested by David.
Cookie's
had a few
good.
Cookies. Cherry. And Charles?
No, I don't like that.
Sorry, Charles. How was that? Cece?
Absolutely not.
Oh, there you go. Lee has sent in this message. Our daughter Bethany, age 6, says the cute dog should be named Coco. Quite a few
Cocos.
That's
nice.
You like Coco?
I like Coco.
I like Clover. Oh, come on, Clover.
Clover? There are more C names than you think, aren't there?
Yes, it's true.
Call the new puppy Crunchy, says Stephanie.
This is one of the most fascinating features you've ever done.
I love it.
5,000 responses. It's actually proving to be quite a hit.
That's what I'm saying, guys.
We're a nation of dog lovers.
Listen, the very best of luck. Good luck with Tom Jones in October.
Thank you.
And good luck at the Old Vic.
Thanks
very
much.
Always
lovely to see you.
Thank you very much indeed. Right, still to come, ladies form an orderly queue. Jimmy's considering a new career in the Dales as a gigolo.
Oh.
Sharon's soap goss is coming up.
And Ryland's here to add a touch of showbiz sparkle with X Factor Gossip. We're back after this break.
This morning, I'm giving Fabulous a try.
Boots sponsors this morning.
Is it a comment or am I on Acorn mint is not just a healthy source of protein, it also makes delicious chili.
Our washing machine's not working as well anymore. I've cleaned the rims and the dispenser, but still no joy.
Limescale and dirt can build up, and it could affect performance. Even a small amount can stop your machine from working properly. Calgon 2-in-1 helps prevent the buildup of limescale and helps to keep your machine working at its best. Washing machines live longer with
Calgon. Germ News Network.
Hello, germs. As you know, when ordinary bleaches flash away, we quickly come back. But the Mestos extended germ kill clings for longer to help stop germs from coming back. Flash! On the flash! On the flash!
The Mestos extended germ kill. Nothing protects as long.
May I humbly present the logo for our purplebricks.com letting service?
Wow, Michael! It's a masterpiece.
Thank you.
A true expression of the freedom that comes from being in the safe hands of our highly knowledgeable local lettings experts.
Exactly. It says just chuck us your keys and we'll do the rest.
Yet you've also captured that dazzling sense of a landlord's joy at all those potential savings in letting agent fees.
That's just what I was going for, Kenny.
And all in purple.
Obviously.
For expert advice and a free valuation, visit purplebricks.com.
Want to get closer?
Let's go. It's 24-7.
From the moment you get up. It's hits.
Hits.
Tune in to Capital.
Boom.
Pow.
Want to be part of it?
Well, now you can.
The biggest artists.
The best music.
The hits now.
London's number one hit music station. Capital.
Red and yellow and pink and purple and orange and blue. I can sing a rainbow, sing a rainbow. You can sing one too.
Special K. You full of deliciousness, rainbow, full of goodness, full of colour. Special K. Live in colour.
Healthy is really important to me, but I never thought toothpaste could make a difference. I found out about this from my dentist. He says, you've got to go pro. Try Oral-B Pro Expert.
What? Why do I need to go pro with my toothpaste?
You know what? He was right.
My teeth feel so much healthier and stronger.
For healthier, stronger teeth, starting from day one, its unique formula helps protect enamel and makes your teeth 10 times stronger.
My first Pro Expert checkup.
Go pro with Oral-B Pro Expert.
All clear.
Up there, Grylls! And I've learned you don't need to go to the ends of the earth to find amazing adventures in Great Britain!
I love it, thank you, Lord.
Britain's biggest adventures with Bear Grylls. Coming soon on ITV.
This morning, it's trigonometry.
Boots sponsors this morning.
Welcome back. Sharon Marshall is here now with all the soap gossip. Where would you like to start? Corrie?
Yes, by the way, should, love this sofa. Right, start off with Coronation Street. Thank you for this, Corrie, because this is the first time that anyone has seen this. It's a little teaser of what the big theme is going to be around the live episode that's coming up the week of the 21st of September. So let's have a look. By the way, this isn't going to actually happen. It's all symbolism of what's happening with the Platts.
OK.
Let's have a look.
Run! You better run.
At the end of the day, you better run in some type of direction, because the people going nowhere are the ones that are flexing. I'm not trying to be a preacher, I was never a reverend, but I can take you at the church and show you glimpses of heaven. You better run in some type of direction, because the people going nowhere are the ones that are flexing. I'm not trying to be a preacher, I was never a reverend, but I can take you at the church and show you glimpses of heaven. You better.
Ooh. So I see what you mean by the symbolism. There isn't a massive sinkhole that's just opened up.
No, it's saying there's nowhere to go for the plats. It's Callum. The theme of the live episode is going to be his revenge. What's going to happen to them?
That must have
them.
Been such fun for them to do.
Can you imagine? Yes. Yeah. And then stop, we're going to put CGI the cliff facing
it
later.
It's fantastic. Yes. So in Coronation Street, are they all frantically rehearsing now? Have rehearsals started for that live event?
Going to start next week, actually. But then they all know what's happening. They've got the scripts. But, yeah, the actual run-throughs are going to be that. It is the whole of the week of the 60th ITV celebrations.
Brilliant.
And also
brilliant.
Going on, you'll get Roy and Kathy, you'll get Andrew and Lloyd having a party, and Tim will find out about Kev Snog with Sally as well.
Oh,
so it's all going to be going on.
What about Emmerdale?
Right. Well, Jimmy is going to be a gigolo.
So we hear.
As soon as he figures out what a gigolo is, because I don't think he quite knows. He's just looking it up in the dictionary in this bit. I think you can do it, Jimmy. Yeah, go on. Let's have a look.
It's not just about age.
What isn't?
Nothing. Rodney is bragging about his career as a gigolo.
Oh, I thought Hunter had retired.
Yeah, well, I was just explaining to Jimmy it's not for everyone. I mean, Jimmy's appeal might be a little, well, niche.
Jimmy. Jimmy, a gigolo.
That's not the reaction he was looking for, is it? I know.
He does go on a date. It goes horribly wrong, but he does go on a date. Poor Jimmy.
So autumn's going to be big, isn't it? What can we expect?
Well, we've seen Jay, of course, his world sort of collapsed around him. He's lost his wife, his mistress, and his son. He's going to getting into drugs, so it's all going to go in a very slippery slope for him. How are we to wear this? A vengeful act threatens the life of one resident.
Someone in mortal peril.
Someone is in mortal peril, yes. So lots of people are going to be under suspicion. Big storyline coming up there. And, drama for Vanessa as well. She's going to be going into premature labour as with her little baby. Oh, there she is!
Okay.
The baby's life will be in danger. Oh, which brings me to EastEnders. Last night is heartbreaking scenes. I think the Masoods were brilliantly. They did it so brilliant last night. It's a stillborn baby. It's such a sad storyline. So just to warn you, anyone at home, we're going to show you a little clip of this. I think it is important to do storylines like this, and I think they did it beautifully, reverentially, and with respect. But if it would upset you, then maybe don't watch this next clip of what's happening next with Shabs and Kush.
We need to bury him today.
Yeah, but...
Post-mortem, are you serious?
The doctor said they can do it for MRI.
So what's the point? Probably won't be able to tell us why he died.
But they might. They might know something. And then when we want to try again...
He's our baby.
Was done terribly
sad.
Very sensitively.
Rakia, and Rakia, the actress there, plays Shabnam. I thought, they were all heartbreakingly good. I thought Pete Lawson wrote it. I thought it was absolutely beautifully done. Big storylines coming up for autumn. Kathy's back.
Yes.
Kathy's back next week. I love it. The person that she calls is Tracy. Tracy's going to get some lines. Tracy the barmaid is going to have loads of lines. She's centre of the action. She's going to be speaking. So Kathy's back. There's going to be Max's trial approaching. Jack Joss is going to come back for a guest role as well, who plays Lauren. Dot's going to be out of prison.
At last.
She's going to be back. Carol Jackson is leaving this autumn as well, but it does mean a little return for Robbie Jackson. Dean Gaffney is going to be doing a little guest as well.
And we're going to say happy 20th anniversary on October the 23rd for Hollyoaks.
Yes.
So they'll begin their celebrations, I'm assuming, now.
Indeed, that's coming up now. So what
they've started. I remember this new, when they first burst on the scene, it was like this new soap for like teenage, I just remember it being pointed at us when I was a kid. Halfway did that 23 years ago.
Yeah. And all these storylines, they're still there. They're still at the forefront. The stuff they're doing is so clever. We're going to be finding out in that anniversary, finally the reveal of the gloved hand killer, which is one of my favourite things of whodunit. This is Perry. We can see on the screen now. She's going to be giving birth to a little baby girl. So this is a teenage storyline. Oh. Will she give this baby away? There's going to be a life or death underwater for three characters as well. And the return of a well-known face. And Hollyoaks' first ever ever gay pride festival is coming up as well. That's going to kick off, as you say, October the 19th, a week of episodes and really big action on screen there.
So, brilliant. All good for the autumn then.
Looking very strong.
Thank you, Sharon. Thank you very much.
Still to come, Gocky's here with the colour of the season. Pink is in.
And Ryland's in the green room, along with Fourth Power, the X Factor Filipino girl band that's getting everybody talking. That's in a couple of minutes.
Next week on This Morning, Leslie Ash, a survivor of cosmetic surgery gone wrong. She takes her own personal look at the perils of changing your looks. A This Morning exclusive, next week.
This morning, I've picked breakfast.
Boots sponsors This Morning.
Ever feel like you go unnoticed? Enough.
L'Oreal Paris, age perfect.
It's the science I trust to help me look like me. Nourish your skin and show those age spots who's boss. Look and feel more radiant.
Age perfect from L'Oreal Paris.
So are we worth it?
More than ever.
Wanna get closer?
Let's go. Capital!
It's 24/7.
From the moment you get up. It's hits.
Hits.
Tune in to Capital.
Boom.
Pow. Want to be part of it?
Well, now you can.
The biggest artists.
The best music.
The hits now.
London's number one hit music station.
Capital.
Walkers are bringing back some of Britain's old favourites. Not them. Classics like my favourite, beef and onion. Yours might be cheese and chive or barbecue.
I said, not you.
Lamb and mint or toasted cheese. Vote for your favourite flavour and we'll bring it back.
Grab a pack, vote, and you could win £100,000.
At Quaker, we've always been known for our natural oat goodness.
Country road, take me.
But now, you can get all the wholesome benefits of oats in a range of delicious new granolas. New Quaker granolas. Keep the goodness going.
Lint excellence. Luxurious sensations in a thin masterpiece. So thin, so intense. Excellence. Experience the unexpected with excellence, a touch of sea salt. Lindt, master chocolatier since 1845.
She used to be so quiet. Now she's busy in the mornings, afternoons, and evenings. It all began with this gel.
Unlike tablets, Voltrol 12-hour gel concentrates relief deep in the joints, fighting pain and inflammation all day long.
Oops.
Now available with easy-to-open cap. Voltrol, the joy of movement.
Disney invites you to bring home the most magical event of the year.
Shall go to the ball.
I'm only a girl, not a princess.
The most beloved fairy tale of all time.
I have to leave.
Told in the most beautiful way. Cinderella, including the Frozen Fever short. Bring it home on Blu-ray and DVD now.
Ariel 3-in-1 pods, rated best on tough stains by Witch. Always keep away from children.
Creating a great engine is like creating a great perfume. Take the best ingredients and reduce them to their essence. Peugeot's PureTech engines are lighter for improved efficiency and agility, with increased torque and power. So you feel a bit like this. The Peugeot 308 with PureTech 3-cylinder petrol engine. Order a 308 now to benefit from 3 years free servicing.
People pretend to be one thing for half a century and then turn out to be something else.
I know nothing about what happened to this young man.
I want to find who took his life and I want to punish them. 39 years later.
New 6-part drama, Unforgotten, this September on ITV.
This morning, it's me versus the weeds.
Boots sponsors This Morning.
She's one of the greatest film actors of all time. In her only UK interview.
Obviously, I had to work really, really hard to get the guts to even walk up on the stage with these people.
Meryl Streep speaks exclusively to This Morning tomorrow.
Welcome back. Still to come, Rylan is here with all the tears, tantrums and triumphs from this weekend's X Factor.
First, though, it's one of this season's hottest shades, but can anyone wear it, or is it just for the young? Well, Gok is here with his favourite pink picks from the high street to get you to right, whatever your age. So where
Absolutely.
Would you like to be? Hello.
Do you know what? Hello. Welcome back.
It's nice to see
Can
you.
Can I say, first of all, it's lovely to have you here. So one of the biggest trends this season is pink, and a lot of people are terrified of it because you can often look like a kid's bedroom.
Or like the lady behind you.
Penelope Pitstop. Absolutely. There's a lot of people out there that have coined the colour pink, and they go head to toe. That's not the way to do it.
Let's have a look at some high street looks.
Absolutely.
Pink, it's one of this season's hottest shades, with big-name designers such as Prada, Chanel and Giorgio Armani all sending it down their autumn-winter catwalks. Celebs such as Kim Kardashian, Amal Clooney and Victoria Beckham have all been looking pretty in pink. Here's how to get the look on the Great British High Street.
Of the world right where I wanna be. So how can this dark cloud be raining over me? But hearts break and hell's a place that everyone knows. So don't be so hard on yourself, no. Don't be so hard on yourself, no.
So that's a high street pink, and the VMAs, Miley Cyrus is wearing pink. Absolutely, yeah, we've got some shots here. So Miley, even Miley
something.
Is a big fan of pink. And now I'm not saying this
in
is how you do
outfit,
it.
In that first outfit, how would you recreate that look?
It's not really an outfit, is it? It looks like she's just jumped herself against a balloon wall or something. That's kind of it. So I'm not saying do this with Miley Cyrus, but there are a lot of celebs out there that obviously love the colour as well. And if you get it right, like you're doing right now
in pink...
I have
got a little bit of pink going on
then
here.
Then it can look incredible, and it's down to two different things. Trust your judgment and skin tone. Very
okay.
important. So, I've got three of our gorgeous real women, the viewers, that are all going to model the looks. And this first look is modelled by Gemma, who's 40 years old. And this is my tribute to Holly.
I love you for
your
for
first
this.
Day back. So, come on down, my darling. So, this shirt is from bonprix.co.uk at £24.99. The trousers from F&F at Tesco's for £18. The bag from Debenhams for £18. And the shoes from Primark at £12.
So, I know what everybody is going to be watching going, hang on. A second, that's not pink.
It
but
is.
This is
it's
what you're
salmon
talking
pink.
About.
Absolutely,
yes.
Pink comes in so many different shades, and we yeah. kind of associate pink with cerise or those kind of baby pinks. It doesn't always have to be. It can no. be a different shade. I love this one. I love the structure of this silky blouse with that print on. It reminds me of a Gucci blouse.
It really does.
I've actually put a shoulder pad in to give it a little bit more structure. But what I've done is I've tucked it into the trousers.
Yeah.
Skin tight boot cut trousers, the biggest trend this season. Put it together with a pair of heels, and you've got this fabulous hourglass.
Is boot cut back?
Boot cut is back.
And I love
it's
the fact that you're an hourglass shape. I mean, you've got yeah. lovely curvy shape, and you're wearing trousers, because I'm a bit scared of wearing trousers because I've got a big old bottom on me. So
but
I'm
you know, Gemma, would you mind turning around? Can we see? Do you mind? I mean, look how incredible.
You do.
If you,
you
hold
really
on
do.
To your form,
you look
absolutely.
Fantastic.
So a bit of a tip here. It's about the colour. So as you can see with Gemma's skin, that salmon tone really suits it. But what I've done is I've anchored it. So whenever you're dressing, you've got to have two different tones. You've got to have an yeah. anchor and an accent. The black is the anchor and the salmon pink is the accent.
Anchor and accent.
And you Beautiful. Actually, reading through your style, you do keep an eye on the catwalk and see whether or not you can recreate
yes.
that, don't you?
I do. Yeah.
And pink is not a stranger to you.
No, and I love these trousers.
Oh, good.
So happy with the
Very
look today?
Happy.
Oh, you look great, very sophisticated.
You're welcome.
Thank
you look beautiful. Thank you so much, Gemma.
Thank you.
Lovely. Right,
next
up, we've got the beautiful Bev. And Bev is 57 years old, so come on out, my darling.
Yeah, you look great.
This top is from New Look at £12.99. The jacket from H&M at £29.99. The trousers from Primark at £14. The bag and shoes are both from New Look. And just to say, all of our credits are on the website if you want to choose anything.
So, you've achieved that magical thing where you look so comfy. I just want to put it on. But also, you look so stylish.
That's what I was going for. When I think about the colour pink and when I'm putting an outfit together, I think about freedom, I think about lightness, I think about floaty. So I've created something with that. And it's about fabrication for this one.
It's only just pink, though, isn't it?
Well, it's the shades of pink, but the trousers are actually white. So you don't have to wear head-to-toe pink. You know, basically, there are no rules with fashion.
You can pretty much wear what you want to. It's like a very, very pale blush rosé.
It is blush. Philip, I love the fact you know it's a blush rosé. I love that.
Of course he knows it's a blush rosé.
Wine!
Oh, of course, the wine. I was thinking shoes.
No.
There you go. You think about wine, I think shoes.
I'm thinking wine.
So it works for this reason. So what I've done is I've used the darker tone on top, the lighter pink underneath, and then the white. So you can see we've built everything up from the bottom all the way to the top. But then I've used the anchor again, and I've used Bev's skin tone and all of those beautiful, rich brown colours
really
in the
nice.
Woods and the handbag as well. Just gives it that sense of class.
So you say you like classic clothes with a bit of a quirky edge.
Yep.
Does this fit the bill?
Yeah, usually I'd go for much darker pink. So this is something really departed from what I'd normally do, but I love it.
No,
but this
great.
Is so much more chic.
Yeah. It is.
So much more chic.
I love the jewellery too.
Yeah, it's
very
beautiful.
Cool.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, my darling.
Thank you.
Right, next up we've got the beautiful Ruth. Now Ruth is 82 years old.
Oh,
I love Ruth so much. Come on out, my darling.
Wow.
You okay?
Ruth.
Right. This top is from M&S at £35. The jacket from Topshop. Whoever says anyone at Topshop's only for the young'uns is wrong. £85. The trousers from Dorothy Perkins at £18. The bag from Hotter.com at £50. And the shoes from Accessorize at £44.
Ruth, you look incredible.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You look really beautiful.
Feel?
I feel fine.
Is this the sort of thing that you would normally wear?
Yes, I would wear pink and grey and pink and black.
Yeah. You know what's so lovely? The soft colours are really beautiful on your skin tone as well, aren't they? They're just really elegant and soft, beautiful.
So what happens is in the mornings I come in and I see all of our models and then we get them styled up. So it happens actually in the morning. And the first thing when I see Ruth is I see that hair colour, that incredible, beautiful silver grey. I absolutely adore it. So what I wanted to do was I wanted to mimic that with all those pink tones.
Yeah.
So using a grey trouser, a grey shoe with the embellishment, and then pulling out this slightly mauvey pink on that top with the embellishment around the neckline. As you can see, everything just complements the hair. And what you've got to do is when you're thinking about tones and colours for a season, you've got to trust your instincts. And a very, very quick tip is if you get those colour charts from DIY stores with all the colours on, just take all of those and build up a little book at home of all the colours that you really like and you really appreciate.
That's a good
and
idea.
Just work out which colours go together.
Hold
and
them
then
on
you
your face.
Absolutely, because it is about skin tone, whether you've got a tan, whether you haven't got a tan, whether you're changing your hair colour. In Ruth's case, just here, it was all about that beautiful, incredible hair colour.
So we found ourselves a silver vixen here. Silver
fox. Thank you.
Ruth, thank you very much indeed.
You look gorgeous. Thank
you.
Hopefully
thank
we'll
you.
See you again. Thank you.
Thank you. Very good. Thank you very much. Right, still ahead. Ryland's ready with the backstage gossip from The X Factor and the act that he says he'd sign up in a shot. Filipino girl band Fourth Power.
Oh, we'll also be giving you another chance to bank £1 million. What more could you want? Look at that. See you after the break.
Tomorrow, Meryl Streep on her rocking roll. In a British exclusive, the actress and her daughter talk about starring together with Meryl as rock star mum.
One day you're going to wake up and find a grey hair.
And I don't mean on your head.
Tomorrow, only on This Morning.
This morning, I'm taking them to the park.
Boots sponsors this morning.
Black Opium, the feminine fragrance. Yves Saint Laurent. Discover now the new Black Opium Eau de Toilette.
It's the Shreddies Good News Team with today's top stories. Everyone's buzzing about honey Shreddies. The nation's going loco for cocoa. And expect showers of frosted Shreddies all morning long. Shreddies fabulous flavors. Good news for everyone.
When you clean, ordinary grease and grime can slow you down. And really tough grime can even stop you in your tracks. But now, Flash Concentrated Cleaner has double the cleaning power. Add it to water, and it makes easier work of even the toughest stains. On the floor, on the hob, and on the kitchen tiles. Flash does the whole house proud.
Everything was working fine, and then the washing machine just broke. With three kids, you just can't do without it.
Without care, your washing machine could let you down. Lime Scout could reduce the lifespan of your washing machine. But you can help prevent this by using Calgon 2-in-1 for cleaner results
and a longer-lasting machine. Washing machines with longer
with Calgon. Corn mint is not just a healthy source of protein, it also makes delicious chili.
When your pets feel good on the inside, it shows on the outside. So give them food that's gentle on their tummies and made with natural ingredients. Wainwright's hypoallergenic food at Pets at Home.
You're acting so funny. What's wrong, Billy?
My doctor says I have Skittles pox.
Skittles pox? Are they contagious?
I don't think so.
Contract the rainbow. Taste the rainbow.
Wanna get closer?
Let's go. Capito!
It's 24/7.
From the moment you get up. It's hits.
Hits!
Tune in to Capital.
Boom!
Pow!
Wanna be part of it?
Well, now you can.
The biggest artists.
The best music.
The hits now.
London's number one hit music station. Capital.
At Unilever, we want our brands to help create a bright future. Persil Small and Mighty is concentrated, so it does the same amount of washing, but is made with less water and uses less packaging, which makes a difference to our planet. Unilever makes some of the world's most well-known brands, and we're working to reduce our environmental impact. Smaller packs are just one of the ways we're helping to create a bright future.
That's it, it's the team with the most pull has a better chance of winning the Rugby World Cup.
So what are you doing?
As for my lot, we'll probably just watch it on the telly.
The 2015 Rugby World Cup on ITV. Show your support and help your nation get the job done.
This morning, the weather may be dull, but I'm feeling bright. Boots sponsors this morning.
Taking me by surprise. Oh, nearly, you nearly made it.
Oh, we're so close.
That's hilarious.
Got to be quicker than that, won't you? Right, welcome back. Coming up, Rylan is here with his X Factor Roundup. We're going to be chatting to him in just a sec.
First, though, let's see if we can make you a millionaire.
It'll be the easiest million you've ever made.
Here's what you need to know for your chance to win the lot.
Text cash to 86060. Text costs £2 plus one standard network rate message. Call 09068 786060. Calls cost £2 plus your network access charge. Or post your name and phone number to MIL3615, PO Box 7558, Derby DE10NQ. Entrance must be 18 or over. Lines close at 5 p.m. on Sunday, the 20th of September. Good luck.
So we were actually talking about the weight of £1 million then. So with the case itself, it weighs 8.5 stone. £1 million in 20s weighs 8.5 stone.
That's a lot, isn't it?
Including the case.
Wowza.
If you want to win that and you're a 3 network user, you might be having a bit of trouble. You might not be able to enter at the moment, but other networks and entry routes are still available.
Best of luck. It's the first day of term for the Loose Women today too. Girls, good morning to you.
Cheers.
What have you got for us?
Good morning. Hi. We're all present and correct. Great to see you back, Holly. Nice set. Looks very nice. And your lovely little doggy. Very cute. We're thinking of names as we speak.
Oh.
We've got lots coming up for you today, including as the Queen becomes the longest reigning monarch next week, what will her legacy be? Is the secret to a happy marriage separate bedrooms?
Yes!
Completely separate. This is the latest trend in America and it's coming over here. If you had a big enough house and enough money, would you prefer separate bedrooms? Also, star of new tricks, Tamsin Althwaite, will be here. And also, which one of us was very happy with all the rain this summer and why? All will be revealed 12:30. See you then.
I wonder who that could be. Right, so £1 million, we're sharing this throughout all the daytime shows.
You've got to go, so, get those Loose Women.
Loose Women, it's their million now. Off you go. Thank you
Eight
very much indeed.
£8.5 stone, off it goes. £1 million.
£1 million is travelling.
It's
million
not pounds our responsibility traveling. Now, it's Loose Women's. And there you
and
go.
And away it goes.
Followed by all the security. It's not just those two, there's a whole line of them. Yeah. Now, The X Factor has officially launched, and while there's a brand new lineup, there is still loads of controversy.
So, thank goodness that Rylan is here to talk us through it all. Let's start, first of all, with Saturday's top act, shall
we? Yeah, so let's start with Saturday's act. But what I'm going to do is I want to show you a little roundup of just everything that happened over the weekend. So take a little look.
High five.
Let's do it.
When you work with me, we're going to make some amazing songs.
Thank you.
You took us to church, girl.
I know you haven't laid your mind to plant. Never felt on the pain I caused. Now the pain is hitting me.
That is what you call a singer.
It was. I mean, what a way to come back. And some brilliant talent already.
Some really good talent. So, you know, it's back with a bang. It's all been going off. They've pulled out all the stops. Let's talk about Saturday nights, people.
Yeah.
First up, we saw Lauren Murray. She's 25. She's the dental receptionist. She sung Jocelyn Brown's Somebody Else's Guy.
Yeah.
What a voice
what a
she
voice.
Had on her. So she was absolutely fantastic. That was the one she was going to sing Whitney. And Simon was like, what Whitney? What Whitney?
Yes.
What Whitney? And she ended up going for that. What a choice. Absolutely fantastic, Sean. So she's
one to
through.
Watch.
She's through to boot camp, definitely one to watch.
And also that it was all, when someone puts themselves forward to such a big show, inevitably there are elements of their past that are then discussed or found out or someone sells a story or whatever. And it's sad there. She had the sudden death of her dad when she was 11 years old.
So very young.
Therapy for that.
Yeah, and she did. And that's obviously come out in the press over the weekend as well. But, yeah, you know, she's a really tough cookie. She's admitted that herself and she's just looking forward to the experience. So we're wishing her all the best of luck. Great singer. Watch out for her.
OK, who else do you want to speak about?
Jennifer. Jennifer Phillips. So 49 years old. She originally was going to sing Beyoncé's Halo or one of a Celine track as well, but the judges decided to get her to sing Shackles by Mary Mary. Tune, can we just put out there? Need to come back. Mary Mary, where are you? So, yeah, she sung that. She was absolutely fantastic as well. And do you know what? It's nice to see the overs giving it as well.
Yeah.
She's 49 years old. You know, she could have been in the girls' category. You know, she was just there giving it and she'd done fantastic. So Jennifer was good.
Let's talk about Josh Daniel. The clip that made Simon cry.
And the rest of the nation watching the TV at that moment. I was in bits.
Yeah, so Josh, he's 21 years old, so he come on and he sung. He lives with his mam, as he kept on saying. He sung a rendition of Labyrinth's Jealous. Now, it did come out during the audition that the reason he chose to perform the song was because, sadly, his friend Tom passed away in 2013. The song was absolutely fantastic. He was amazing, and it obviously hit heartstring. It was very close to...
the tribute at the end, which explained that Simon had lost his
Which was lovely. Course,
which was lovely. And then this was the Sunday show.
So I think
because it was very delicately played, a lot of people who maybe saw the Sunday show wouldn't have known why he got so emotional.
And online as well, there was a lot of people online saying, oh, Simon, you know, how embarrassing, he's crying, it's all for the cameras. I think people need to be a bit more
and
sensitive
you could
and realise.
And Cheryl's reaction, like, that reaction of her was seeing her friend hurting.
It affected everyone there. It really, really did. Let's have a look.
I'm going to sing Jealous by Labyrinth.
And tell me why you've chosen that song.
It means a lot to me for a different reason, I think, to how Labyrinth wrote it.
Which is?
I lost my best friend a couple of years ago. When you left me, there's
nothing to forgive. That was the most captivated I've been in all the auditions so far.
Thank you.
Sorry, I'm very emotional and you really touched me. I believed every word you sang.
Yeah,
she did well there, Cheryl.
Yeah, and you know what? Really, really heart-wrenching to watch that
but
for
also
everyone.
At the end of the show there, he got straight onto golf buggy, straight in the car, straight away.
Off and done.
What about Sean?
Yeah, let's talk about Sean. So, Sean, he's 24 years old. Yeah. He's from Australia. He's rumoured to have bought a one-way ticket to the UK. His family live here because he feels that he's a lot more accepted in our culture over here.
He's got the most incredible voice.
I mean, just voice, like... legs, waist. I mean, every woman I've spoken to just hates him because he's like perfect. Amazing.
You know when you watch somebody and they have a moment on stage?
That was his moment.
He had it.
And I got a lot of tweets saying, oh, it's the new Ryle, and the only difference is he can sing. But he don't look as good in the skirts, mate. Put it out there. But the one standout act for me this weekend was our Filipino girl group.
Weren't they brilliant?
They were stunning. I teased them on Thursday's episode. I absolutely love them, and I think we should have a look why.
And they join us now!
Hello, girls!
Hey!
Here they come!
Ladies,
hi,
welcome,
ladies!
Welcome!
Come and have a seat, sit down! Almira and Cindy.
Nice meeting you all.
Well, Saturday night we were watching. I felt like we weren't watching an audition stage of The X Factor. I felt like it was a live show. You girls were so polished. Is that part of it? You've been doing this for obviously a very, very long time.
Yes. We've been singing since we were little, and you know, because we come from a humble beginning, this is our way of like helping our parents to like, you know, better our lives and finish studies. So that's why every time we practice at home and we make our best to, you know, show to people.
Well, there was an element of controversy, as there always is with these sort of things, is that you are, you've taken part in a show in Manila.
Yes.
So the sort of X Factor show over there. And you've done quite a lot of things.
Yeah.
So you are already very polished. I'm not entirely sure I understand the criticism because you go wherever you think you could get your break. Mm. You're still looking for your break. And is that why you're here?
Yes. That's why we're here, because we're chasing our dreams whenever, you know, it's possible, because we wanted to reach our dream of like having that prize and, you know, helping our family to have our own house, not to be, you know, transferring in different parts of the Manila because we don't have anything to pay. So we're looking and searching for a dream, and that's why we found
X Factor. And so you said on the show that you came to the X Factor, yes. the UK X Factor, because it was the biggest, the best. You wanted Simon Cowell there. Yeah. So to get that reaction from those judges, what did that feel like?
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my God. It was crazy. Oh, my. It was insane. It was like a dream come true. It's really, literally, we're like floating in the air. When like there we got standing ovation from all the judges and like seeing Simon Cowell.
And he was the famous judge for us and in the Philippines. Like, he is straightforward in his critic, and we thought he's gonna be rude for us, but he's not. He's just, when we saw the standing ovation, we're like crying and breaking down on stage that this is really not happening.
How about your mum? Because she was there as your sort of manager, your mummager. And she, so she must have been so proud.
Yes, very much. She was our number one fan. She made our costumes when we were little, and she's the one who pushed us to like, no, just wait for your break. Don't ever give up.
Well, girls, thank you very much indeed.
Good luck tomorrow for the film. Yeah, good luck.
Thank you.
Let's just bring our
star of the show.
Oh, she is.
He's sent social media into a meltdown. Let me tell you, thousands of you want to take part in naming our friend, with Scylla being the most popular name so far. Okay. How about that? Well, if you want to take part officially, you can go to our website, itv.com. You have been very gorgeous and very good, as have you.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. On tomorrow's show, we'll be hearing from the First Lady of Hollywood, that's Meryl Streep, as she reveals how she literally shed blood, sweat and tears for her latest role.
The holidays may be coming to an end, but Bryony shows us how to keep our gorgeous summer glow.
And there's heartbreak ahead for Fizz and Tyrone. Corrie's Jenny McAlpine has all the gossip from the cobbles. That's all at 10:30 tomorrow. We'll see you then. Bye.
See you later. Bye.
Well, a mysterious stranger turns up in Emmerdale just in time for Val's funeral tonight. We're there at 7 before our prehistoric predecessors are brought vividly back to life at 8 in our stunning new series, Dinosaur Britain. Next this afternoon, back and on great form with Tamsin Althwaite among their guests, it's an all-new series of Loose Women.